Read what it says.
I know thy works.
Come on.
That thou art neither cold nor hot. I would thou wert cold.
Now, we had Laodicea now. We looked at Ephesus. They lost their first love. We looked at Smyrna. They were poor. They had poverty within their ranks. But Jesus said, you're rich. Yeah. We're looking at Laodicea now. Revelation 3 and 15. The church of the Laodicea. Now we remember in the Ephesus, the Nicolaitan, where the pulpit or the clergy dominated the laity. But in Laodicea, the laity began to try to tell the pulpit what to do. So let's look at Laodicea, Revelation 3 and 15. Read it.
I know thy works.
Come on.
Thou art neither cold nor hot.
Yeah, but the problem with the pews at this time, they are not like Ephesus, where their works, they had good works. They're neither cold nor hot.
All right. That's right. Come on.
You're right.
Read what it said.
I would thou were cold or hot.
I'd rather that you were all the way cold.
That's right. Come on.
All the way hot.
Okay.
Read what the word said.
So then, because thou art lukewarm.
But because you are lukewarm, you are straddling the fence.
Yeah.
You right there in the middle. He says what?
And neither cold nor hot.
And you're neither cold, wrong, hot, right. You lukewarm. You look like you're right, but you're not. Read what it said.
I will spew thee out of my
mouth. I'm going to spit you out. Right. Read it.
Because thou sayest, I am rich.
Because the fact is, you're saying you're rich. Now, you have to understand something. Physically, they are. The Laodicean church age that we're in now is where that the wealth of the sinner will be given into the hands of the judge. The church is, boy, y'all going to be rich. Only one or two people make you believe that. He said, I'm going to transfer it into your hands, into your control. It may not be in your bank account down at your bank, but it'll be under your control. As long as I got control of it, help me, hold it up. Can I preach for 1 minute? When I had that episode with Cooper, I had control over Cooper for about 10 days. Why do you think she kept trying to call me?
Come on, man.
I called her once. Got her voicemail. And I left the right message. Y'all not in. And she began to call me last week, 10 days ago. Kept calling. And told me she kept calling. It's because I had control. Because they were wrong. They had my money. But they're giving me service. Y'all not here. And you can have control of a thing without owning the thing. And as long as you can control the thing, and God said, I'm going to give all of the wealth, all of the control, all of the good things that come along with wealth, it's going to be given to you. But the Bible talks about those things that God gives. He said it doesn't bring sorrow, the blessings of the Lord. What he give them, they bring no sorrow.
Amen.
So you can have the control of the wealth without the worry.
Amen.
It's more worry right
Amen.
Now. They're about to lose it. Oh, I wish I had time. I don't. But he says, you say you're rich. You say what?
And increase with good.
I got all kind of stuff.
Read. And have need of nothing.
And I don't need nothing. Read.
And knowest not that thou art wretched and miserable and poor and blind and naked.
But no say. Good God Almighty. You got so many zeros at the end of your bank account. But he said, you need to know something. First of all, you're wretched. You're not worth much. He said, you poor. You see all that money up there, but that's not really yours. That's somebody else. Your name on the account, but that's really those out there in T.O.P. He said, and you're blind, and you can't see that it's not yours.
Amen.
And you instead of being greedy and making, he said, the Bible said, Timothy, as Paul wrote to Timothy, he said, they are heaping up the riches for this last day. They're heaping it, someone say heaping it up.
Amen.
But they blind, they don't realize it's not for them. Tell them they poor. given the promised land, God said, I have given it up to your hands. He said, now go take it.
That's right.
So I just don't give my Gucci. Keep buying your expensive this and your expensive that. You buying it for me?
Amen. All right.
God said, I'm going to give you houses that you didn't build.
That's right.
Somebody right now got an architect design the house, right? See, the only reason you're in the house you're in, that's because that's the house of the house being built right now.
Amen.
That's your house.
Amen.
Get ready to take it.
Amen.
Read what he says.
He opened the bottomless pit.
Now, excuse me. That Laodicean church, let me finish that up. Again, the laity began to dominate the pulpit. And they said because they had some riches, I have this, I have no need of nothing. I don't need this. But when they were the Ephesus church, they realized that they were being dominated by the pulpit. And the Bible said that was our hatred. The pews, the lamp, they hated.
That's right.
And they could look at the pulpit. Mm-hmm. And Jesus, I hated it too.
Mm-hmm.
Nothing wrong with hating something that's right. Messing with you.
Yeah.
Because you're not, unless you're. He said it this way.
Ooh.
If God, he used the same word, the Greek word, hated. That's the same word we can do. We're not hating them on a personal level. I'm not talking about hating a person on a personal level. I'm talking about hating a system. You should despise certain systems. And you should have a hatred for it, because hatred gives a motivation in you to cause you to change.
Yeah.
Stuff that you don't hate, you won't change.
That's right.
As long as you put up with him balling his fist and beating you in your mouth, you'll keep letting him do it.
Yeah.
But one day you wake up, you just say, I'm not going to take this no more. Do like Lord, pull that pants leg up. Pull that sleeve up. Y'all know the story. I saw, I said, Mama, what you doing? She said, you just keep on. I'm going to show you. But the Laodiceans tried to control the pulpit. So both of them are wrong.
Amen.
It's not for the pulpit to control the lip, and not right for the lip to control. Somebody say we are
laborers,
one another, for God.
Amen.
Along with this.
That's right.
As I close. In Revelation 9 and 2, as we look at the various demons that were coming out of the bottomless pit, the Bible styles them as locusts. In that third verse, the Bible says that came out of the smoke, because the smoke preceded the locusts. Those locusts were demons. And the smoke gives the idea of their power. So then the scripture says in that third verse, they came out of the smoke, locusts upon the earth. Unto them were given power or authority as scorpions have power. The seventh verse told us the shape of the locust. I've condensed this. This is not the actual. I just took out ands and these and those, okay? And the shapes of the locusts were what they were like. They were like horses, and their faces were like the faces of men, and their hair was like the hair of women. They had teeth like teeth of lions, and their tails were like scorpions, and they sting with their tails, and they had power to hurt men for 5 months. And if you read a little further into those scriptures, the Bible said that's where men sought to die. They wanted to die, but death flee from them. They couldn't even die. They flee from them. They couldn't even die. And in the 11th verse, they said they had a king over them. And the angel of the bottomless pit, this is a fallen angel that's a devil, a demon, that's the king of the bottomless pit. And in Hebrew, his name is Abaddon, and in Greek, his name is Apollyon. In the Bible, we only see the names of about four devils. We see Lucifer himself, Satan. We see his name. When they accuse Jesus of being the Lord of the flies, Beelzebub, that's the only other devil, a demonic name that we've heard. We heard again when Jesus was going to cast out a devil, we heard the name Legion. We heard once again in this bottom of the pit, we heard of the name Apollyon. Four. Y'all better, anybody with me? We don't need to know every devil's name. All we